For the next couple of pages, I'm going to be working with a little bit heavier material. So I'm going to be using my mixed media visual journal. The other one is thinner paper, mostly for dry or mild collaging. But I want to be using thicker paper and fabric, napkins and cardboard. This is one of those filters from the coffee places, the holder. And the napkin, as I mentioned before, is where I clean my very watery acrylics. And you just, I mean, any variation that you can make, this is the thickest napkin. You just pretty much open it, and the thicker parts of the acrylic is going to be pretty much glued. You either can use it together, the two plies, or separate them gently. Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend Martha. If you are art inclined, love painting, drawing, art journaling, and mixed media, this is your channel. In this particular case, I got a little bit of tears in here, but I don't really mind. So, gather your collaging material. I could also go ahead and use thicker fabric. I probably will, but in a different page. For now, I'm going to use this. Other little scraps that I have here, they can go in the other book as well, but since I'm going to be working on this one, I'm going to be using them now. These are the pages that I'm going to be working on. There. This is just a brush cleaning that I had. I love this color, and it's very rough because it had clear gesso. Not that it matters, but this is what it is in here. And as for this and any other paper with a lot of texture, I would go and use the collage glue or this other glue and seal from Ranger or medium gel. This one is matte. I prefer matte, but whatever you have that is thicker, although I love working with the fluid matte medium, some papers just need a little thicker adhesive. So, with no rhyme or reason, I'm going to just put my papers in here. This is the tool. I'm going to use it in two different ways. One is in here for this display, and later on, we're going to use it again. This is the biggest pattern that you can find. The other one is very fine, and this one is kind of more rough. This is just brown paper from like a bag or the craft paper in a roll, whatever you have available. And we're going to be wrinkling it as much as you want. If you want less creases, don't wrinkle it so much. If you want more creases in any shape that you can just tear it, I'd rather not use straight edges. They glue better if it is torn. And just, you know, play with it. Wrinkle it as much as you want. Cut it in the shape that you prefer. I'm going to use the two different brown papers, and one in each page. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to go from here. But let's say that more or less this is the order. Okay, I'm going to start speeding up the process. Make all the wrinkles you want, but make sure that you don't have any bubbles under the paper. And if it tears, put a little bit of the medium on your finger or in your tool. In this case, I'm using my finger because the napkin is so fragile. Usually I don't like to put goop in my fingers, but for this, is a bit necessary. If you like this video, share it in all your social networks. I'm going to leave on purpose some of the part of the paper without any medium to have the paint on top working differently than in the rest of the paper. And it is okay if you have a little bit hanging from outside your page. That just makes flipping the pages more interesting or easier sometimes. If you're new here, remember to click on the subscribe button and also tick the bell so you get notifications every time I upload a new video. All you will see in the playlist here is acrylic painting, art journaling, all kinds of fun, free paintings and activities. Okay, that should do it for now. And since it is very heavily textured as well, I'm going to let it dry for probably the rest of the day. And I'm going to be working on a different kind of texture project in the next video.